IoT device commissioning, our today's topic. Stefan, what can you tell us about it?
At COPA-DATA, we try to give samples to our engineers and engineers in general, users, end users, in order how to tell them how to use the means of Zenon, of the Zenon software system, in order to develop and to design IoT architectures. IoT in that context means a lot of devices in the field, and on the other hand side, cloud-based services, cloud-based systems, which need access to those values,
right,
and correspondingly have to be connected. Mm. What we have prepared here is a showcase, an IoT showcase, a sample, which shows on the screen, this could be like in a control room, on the screen, the display of a specific device which delivers its values in real time, delivering values to that gateway, to the Zenon gateway in this case, and the gateway forwarding this information into the cloud, where it can be used for specific analysis, for archiving and so on.
So I guess scenarios like predictive or any others are possible with that.
Yes, exactly. The challenge now can be that you have in the field, you want to install specific sensors very quickly without special knowledge about the technology even. So this sample shows how you can do that using the Zenon software system. I'm switching over to the Zenon editor now to show you how easy it can be to integrate a new device into the environment. What I have here prepared is a specific screen.
Template screen, yeah.
Exactly. And a specific symbol in the symbol library. Now I have the possibility to drag and drop this symbol into the screen. And now what is getting active is a wizard. It's something we call automatic engineering. The system tells me, okay, somebody wants to do something. Somebody triggers an action. And in this case, it pops up in a configuration wizard.
Okay. So for the device, I can imagine.
Exactly. So now in this sample, there are a few settings which may be configured, general settings like IP address, something which I maybe just in time receive from an IT department, for example. Other settings like if you want to upload this data, which is transferred from the device to the Zenon gateway, if you want to forward that into the cloud, if you want to have special calculations on that, and so on and so on. Otherwise, there are specific settings for the field level behavior of that device, which kinds of IOs you want to have, if you want to scale them, and so on and so on. In order to make this more efficient, you can, for example, use like a QR code scan. You may try that with the smartphone. So, like you know it from the airport, you can take this one and bring it to the camera.
Let's see if I'm capable of doing that.
Okay, so now it has been recognized. Very easy. In the background, it just filled up the information in the form. You may receive this information, the barcode or some other configuration item from some other department or from some predefined set of profiles you may want to apply to the device.
So I can imagine that this QR code is now fixed to one of these devices, whatever this is, and the field engineer is just being out there and connecting it physically to my infrastructure.
Exactly. So this ties very well into the also the organizational component of the IoT. There's a convergence between departments, OT, IT, that's there is some necessity to bring information from one domain to the other.
Of course, yeah.
So I can now go on in this wizard. Let's say we want to upload the data directly into the cloud. Deploy it. So in the background, now again, via the means of automatic engineering, via an API, which lets me configure every single item, any property, any object in the engineering code or in the engineering project, the wizard does this now in the background.
Completely automatically.
Exactly. Okay, based on the settings which I have made. By the way, it's just a sample. This scheme, this method can be expanded or
adapted, I guess, then to any use case.
Exactly, structured as required for the specific use case. So finally now, the wizard has done its job. And it will now, sooner or later, reload my Zenon runtime.
So also this works automatically. So I don't have to power the system down or restart it. It's the complete value chain is done automatically.
Exactly. So due to our configuration, also this value now, the value of the brightness sensor shall go up into the cloud. So let's have a check. That's the second device here. So anyways on the, let's say in the control room, I have the information already in real time. And as you can see on the right hand side in this indication, this is the value once it has been sent up. We read it back into the control room, and this is indicated in the green line on the right side. So we have a live connection now from device level. This could be any kind of direct driver to any kind of PLC, let's say, integrated into the into that Zenon convergence layer, into that communication layer, and then transferred up via the Zenon process gateway into the IoT.
Cool. Very impressive.
Or into the cloud.
Very impressive. Must say, never seen something like that. That's really a smart solution. Stefan, thanks. As a small offer, I have a t-shirt here for you. Thanks for joining me at Engineer's Kitchen. Hope to see you soon in another session.
Sure.
Bye.
Thank you.
What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.